part of what has made Itaewon a popular place is the nightlife, is the diversity of places that people can go. For that to not be protected, it's quite a disservice actually, because you know it's the foundation of what the area really is about.
I think people have just been avoiding Itaewon for longer than they needed to.
그래서 이제 지금 폐업하는 클럽들도 엄청 많고 못 버티는 클럽들도 엄청 많아지고 있는데
여기 오시는 분들 중에 그분이 아마 50대나 40대 후반일 텐데 농협에 다니시는 아저씨인데 자녀분이 초등학교 5학년이에요. 만날 때마다 힘내셔야 됩니다. 힘내셔야 됩니다. 더 저희 아들 데리고 와야 돼요. 라고 이렇게 얘기를 할 때마다 정말 많이 감동을 받거든요.
This is the Seoul neighborhood of Hongdae. And for much of Seoul, this is what life looks like on the other side of a pandemic. South Korea remains one of the rare countries to never impose a lockdown, but still get the spread of the coronavirus under control. At the height of the COVID crisis, South Korea was registering around 1,000 new cases in a single day. Today, that figure is down to about 30 to 40 cases a day, with testing still in its thousands. But while much of Seoul now looks like this, the streets of one neighborhood remain eerily empty. Itaewon, a once thriving international neighborhood that's also home to the city's underground club scene, hasn't really bounced back like the rest of Seoul. On May 8th, a few days after relaxation of its social distancing guidelines, Seoul reported a spike of 12 new COVID cases after weeks of single-digit rises in the infection rate. Nearly all these cases were centered on a handful of bars and clubs in Itaewon. And suddenly a trendy neighborhood was now trending for an entirely different reason.
Itaewon 주민들을 그래서 상대로 용산구청에서 다 메시지를 보내가지고 코로나 검사를 받게 한 적이 있었어요. 그 사건이 터졌을 때. 그래서 이태원에 있는 클럽 업주들, 음식점 업주들, 주민들 용산구청 가서 코로나 검사를 다 받았었어요. 여기서 제일 중요한 게, 제일 신기했던 게 이태원 주민들은 한 명도 확진자가 없어요. 그 검사 결과를 보면. 나라에서 클럽 인식이 엄청 안 좋고 클럽을 문화로 안 보는 경향밖에 없는 거죠. 경향밖에 없어가지고 이제 지원 같은 거를 안 해주거든요. 그래서 이제 저희는 여유롭게 기다릴 수가 없는 거예요. 그래서 이제 지금 폐업하는 클럽들도 엄청 많고 못 버티는 클럽들도 엄청 많아지고 있는데 외부 사람들이 저녁 때 저녁을 먹고 이태원에 이제 가게들도 이쁜 가게랑 맛있는 음식점들 많잖아요. 저녁을 먹고 그다음에 술집, 클럽 이런 로테이션이 되게 활성화되어 있던 곳이었는데 클럽이 없으면 물론 술집도 술 먹고 갈 데가 없으니까 술집도 점점 사람이 줄고 또 술집도 많이 없어지면 이제 밥집까지 타격을 받는 거예요. 밥 먹으러 이태원 왔다가 사람들이 집으로 다시 돌아가진 않잖아요. 그러니까 악순환이 될 것 같아요.
Amongst the major commercial areas in Seoul, Itaewon's had the highest vacancy rate in the past few months, nearly four times the city's average. Now, local businesses wonder if they can recover from the combined blow of the pandemic and the stigma of being a COVID cluster site.
Plant started about 7 years ago. It's a vegan shop, so we do everything plant-based. The first couple years of operating, that was kind of like, for me at least, the prime of Itaewon, where it was always busy. Every weekend was, you know, something going on. in the beginning when Corona first started, it was a definite slowing down of business. Like people just weren't going out that much. We went down about like 50% of what we normally do. And then the whole Itaewon cluster hit, and that was like immediate like drop of like anybody walking in through the door. Like during the day we had maybe a handful of tables coming in the whole day, and we were just like, okay, so like what are we doing? We felt kind of stupid just like opening up business. So when that happened, we closed shop and we just focused on delivery. With the cases starting at these clubs, which are known as like gay clubs, I think there's some homophobia with that too.
The government found that a man linked to several of the coronavirus cases had visited some of the clubs in the area that were known for being LGBTQ+ friendly. The resulting Itaewon cluster coverage developed a homophobic tinge when the South Korean media started singling them out as gay clubs. Seoul Community Radio, a station and bar promoting the works of indie musicians and homegrown talent, has seen how the music scene has been directly affected in the past few months.
You don't really have the chance to do events now. COVID has really sort of taken a little bit of the wind out of the sails in terms of Itaewon's overall reputation. If you talk to a lot of the clubs, the major problem for them at the moment is that people not being allowed to dance, which is kind of a shame for any club, right?
People can't like enjoy themselves anymore. A few years ago, dancing was illegal in Japan, right? And then we just like make fun of it. Oh, you can't dance in Japan. But now this thing started in Korea.
So during COVID, we've got this platform called Community Service, which is all about helping the businesses like sort of directly around us and close to us. And sort of having that community radio spirit, but using like our new space for them to basically come in and try and sort of like earn some revenues for them that they otherwise wouldn't be able to do because they're shut or their traffic is down. It seems like Itaewon was unfairly stigmatized for sort of like being responsible for the outbreak, when in reality, it was people coming into Itaewon that was the source of that outbreak.
From other cities.
That's right.
Clubs like Faust are still shut, but as the rest of Seoul is already reopened for business, Seoul's nightlife seems to be left out of its plans.
이렇게 쓱 피해 나가서 저희들의 살 길은 열어주지 않고 그렇다고 서포트가 되지도 않고 법적으로 뭐 이거는 저희는 때로 협회에서도 얘기하지만 그냥 죽으라는 건가? 다 그냥 뭐 얘네는 클럽이 보기 싫은 건가? 나라에서는 이 문화는 정말 가치가 없다고 생각하는 건가? 아니면 우리가 아직 그 목소리를 못 내서 그 정부에 아직 그런 목소리가 달하지 못했나? 이런 생각이 좀 듭니다. 이렇게 뭔가를 제도적으로 막아놨으면 저희들이 살 길을 마련해줘야 되는데 그러한 솔루션이나 아니면 페이먼트가 하나도 없이 지원, 서포트가 하나, 금전적인 지원이 하나도 없이 그냥 무조건 막혀있는 상태로 지금 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 5개월을 저희들이 아무것도 못하고 있거든요. 여기에는 정부에서는 정말 소수일지 몰라요. 그렇지만 이 안에는 이 문화가 특히 한국의 뭐 K-POP, K-컬처 이런 것들이 나오기 이전에 앞서서 이런 소규모의 이런 업장이라든지 이런 문화를 소중히 생각하고 움직여왔던 그 많은 사람들이 없었다면은 그런 K-컬처라는 거나 K-팝이라든지가 흥할 수 없었다고 저희는 생각해요. 근데 그것들을 그냥 무시한 채 너희들은 이미지가 안 좋아, 너희들은 위험군이야, 그래서 너희는 그냥 무조건 셧다운.
South Korea scored an early win when it comes to controlling the spread of the coronavirus. But with no real end of COVID in sight and repeated blows to the businesses, this landmark neighborhood faces an uncertain future.
뭔가 계속 고인물이 되기 쉽고 계속 변화를 주고 싶어요. 그래서 되든 안 되든 열심히 노력을 해보고 있어요. 엄청난 마이너스를 겪고 있죠.
Clubs are not places for bad people run by bad people. They're places of culture and emblems of modern Korean sort of collaboration. It allows sort of like creativity to flourish.
I feel like Itaewon has this like grit to it, and it's got this scrappy nature that it'll figure it out. Like, I'm not hoping or even optimistic that it'll go back to what it used to be. I think that Itaewon is kind of in the past now, and we just have to try to create something new now.